Hi, in this video I'm going to show you how to watch BBC Abroad. Now, for anybody outside the UK who's ever tried to access the BBC, you'll have come across this particular problem. If I go to the BBC website and I'm not in the UK, it basically looks at my IP address and redirects me to the sort of international version of the BBC, if you like. You can see there's adverts on here which you wouldn't get on a normal BBC site. And also, if you go to the TV section where you would normally be able to watch BBC Live and whatever's streaming at the moment, so you'd basically be like watching a TV set, you get lots of adverts and links to different BBC websites and how you can get which cable suppliers provide them, stuff like that. You can't actually watch anything on them. As I say, basically, it's looked up my IP address, detected I'm not in the UK, and put me to this international site. If I go to BBC iPlayer, let's just go to BBC iPlayer there. It'll let me go to the BBC iPlayer site if I go directly to it, but if I try and watch anything, I'll get this message. So you can't watch any programmes on this. I think you can watch some of the, listen to some of the radio programmes rather, but you can't watch anything. It's a pain. Lots of people love BBC. It goes the same with other UK stations as well. Some people just on holiday want to watch. They might have a BBC license or whatever, and they just happen to be out of the country. Still can't watch it. Okay, I'm going to show you one way of doing it. I'm going to show you on the PC, but the way I'm showing you can be done on tablets, laptops, smartphones, even some smart TVs, using similar methods, using the same software anyway. Okay, let me close that down. I'm going to show you a program that I use and have used for many, many years called Identity Cloaker. This is a security program that allows you to route your internet connection through any one of the servers in their network. Now, they've got quite a big network here and they've got loads and loads of UK servers. Okay, and that's mainly because literally thousands of people use this application for watching the BBC, just like I do. Right, so how does it work? Well, basically it sits in your taskbar, and if I want to have a UK IP address, or any other country for that matter, if you want to watch German TV or US TV, just pick that country. But I'm going to show you BBC now. I'll pick the fastest one. And then that will now route my entire internet connection via a one of their UK servers, and crucially I'll get a UK IP address. Okay, so let me just start my browser again. This time you should see I've not been rerouted to the international BBC website. It's looked and it's seen this Identity Cloaker IP address, which is based in the UK. You can see now if I go to the TV section, instead of having all those adverts, I can actually watch TV. So I could click on and watch something there. And I also have the iPlayer icon there as well. So let's just test that this works. BBC News is currently streaming. So there we go. So I'm watching the news live on the BBC. Because I've got a BBC, got a UK IP address. Now, it is a subscription-based service. It only costs a few euros, a few pounds a month. It's very cheap. Basically, that money is used to fund the network and to make sure that the servers are fast. Remember, they need to be very, very fast servers. This is why you can't find free ones on the internet, because they're always much too slow and they won't handle video. You need something fast so you can stream it through. The Identity Cloakers are really quick. You can get a trial account which just lasts for 10 days if you want to try it out. It's also quite handy for holidays if you don't want it for a month or something like that. I think it's about 7 euros, something like that. And it just lasts for 10 days, but it's fully functional and you can use it to watch stuff in the US, Australia, Ireland, wherever, and the BBC and all the UK channels as well. And that's basically it. Well, thank you for watching. I hope this has given you some insight into how to watch BBC Abroad, and I'll finish now. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.